Leak in Keystone Pipeline spills 9,000 barrels of oil in North Dakota. It's the second significant spill on the Keystone system since 2017, when around 4,700 barrels spilled in South Dakota. More than 9,000 barrels of oil are estimated to have spilled from a leak in the Keystone Pipeline in northeastern North Dakota, the company said. It's the second significant spill in 2 years in the pipeline that runs from Canada's tar sands region and through 7 U.S. states. Crews shut down the pipeline after the leak was discovered Tuesday night, Carl Rockman, North Dakota's Water Quality Division Director, told the Associated Press. The oil spill affected a wetlands area. TC Energy, formerly known as TransCanada and which operates the pipeline, said Thursday that an estimated 9,120 barrels of oil, enough to fill half of an Olympic-sized swimming pool, was released in the spill. Using that initial estimate, that amounts to around 383,000 gallons. The company says it won't know the exact amount until oil recovery has been finished. The leak occurred near the company's facilities near Edinburg, a community of around 200 people in Wash County around 60 miles northwest of Grand Forks, TC Energy said. The North Dakota Department of Environmental Quality said the leak was 3 miles northwest of Edinburg. Our emergency response team contained the impacted area, and oil has not migrated beyond the immediately affected area, TC Energy said in an earlier update. It said that crews remain focused on oil recovery and will then make repairs to the pipeline. Crews are using vacuum trucks and backhoes to recover the oil, it said. Rockman told the AP that some wetlands were affected, but not any sources of drinking water. In November 2017, more than 200,000 gallons of oil, around 4,700 barrels, leaked in South Dakota. The leak occurred in a sparsely populated area of Marshall County, near Amherst in the northeastern part of the state. The $5.2 billion pipeline is designed to carry crude oil across Saskatchewan and Manitoba, and through North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, Kansas and Missouri on the way to refineries in Patoka, Illinois, and Cushing, Oklahoma, and it can handle 23 million gallons daily. TC Energy is also seeking to build the Keystone XL pipeline that would begin in Hardisty, Alberta, and go to Steel City, Nebraska. Because the pipeline would cross an international border, the U.S. State Department is collecting public comments on its revised environmental impact statement for the pipeline, NPR reported Thursday. An October 4 entry in the Federal Register says the public comment period is expected to end on November 18.